Fake news, bots and trolls. What's the big deal? I'm Naja Bentzen. I work at the European Parliamentary Research Service and I will explain how disinformation affects us and our democracies. False rumors, half-truths and deliberate lies designed to deceive you, in other words, disinformation, have always been around. But on social media, they spread instantly via bots, automatic accounts that interact on the internet, and trolls, people who work to push certain narratives or to bully, distract or confuse people. In addition, real, normal users retweet false news 6 times faster than they spread real news. At the same time, the techniques to catch our attention, confuse us or trick us are getting more and more sophisticated. Manipulated videos, so-called deep fakes, are designed to make us think that people have said or done things they did not say or do. So, if you hear or see me say, the earth is flat, don't worry, I would never say that. It was just a trick. When we face a tsunami of shocking headlines and images that make us feel scared, disgusted, or angry, we use our oldest and quickest system of thinking based on instinct instead of our slower, analytical and rational system. But when we take big, important decisions that will affect us all in the future, for example about who we want to rule our country or our continent, we want to be able to take conscious decisions based on objective facts and trustworthy information. Disinformation confuses us and undermines our trust in the media, in institutions, and in democracy. We know that some foreign authoritarian state actors who do not allow freedom of expression and do not respect human rights at home are working to discredit and destabilize our open democracies. They use disinformation to exploit our fear and angst in order to increase divisions and polarize the debate. And that makes it easier to pit different groups against each other. The EU is already acting to fight disinformation without compromising freedom of expression. In 2015, the European Council asked the High Representative to set up a task force to address the Kremlin's disinformation campaigns. The European Parliament has created a new spokespersons unit that works to tackle false news, among other tasks. The EU has also funded tools to verify the authenticity of photos and videos. Parliament asked the Commission to look into the problem of fake news, and in April 2018, the Commission put forward an action plan with a number of new steps, including an independent European network of fact-checkers and more support for quality journalism and media literacy. The EU has also put pressure on online platforms to be transparent and take more responsibility, and the tech companies have agreed on a code of practice to counter fake content and fake accounts. To fight disinformation and make sure that everyone has access to trustworthy information, we all need to contribute. National governments, EU institutions, news media, online platforms, teachers, fact-checkers, children and parents. Parents are role models for their children, even in the way we consume news. What you and I can do here and now is keep a cool head. Slow down, check the facts and take time to think.